Welcome to Real Talk, Real Women. My name is Miriam Kaladi and today we have author, vegan chef and holistic health wellness coach Tess Jealous on the show. Welcome Tess, how are you?
Good, how are you doing, Miriam?
I'm fine, thank you so much for your time. Can you explain to us here in Europe what it means when you say holistic health?
To me, holistic health means that it's really important to look at all aspects of our being. This is an interesting question. I haven't been asked this in a while. But that's probably the reason why all three of my books contain not just healthy recipes, but also tips on creating a state of inner wellness. So to me, holistic health encompasses everything we need to be a truly full-functioning, thriving human being. Exercise, meditation, visualization, eating right, it's all so important.
So where did your interest in holistic health come from?
Well, I would say that it originally came from the fact that I was a very unhealthy child. I grew up and I had just health problem after health problem. And then I went through a series of things like depression, anxiety attacks. And so I really had to learn basically how to become my own caretaker. I had to learn how to medicate myself without using medication because I didn't want to just take antidepressants or anti-anxiety medications. I really wanted to, just like with food, I don't want to take a pill for something. I want to just make it better at the source, at the root of where it's been created. And that way we don't have reoccurring issues. We just clear them up. We go through them and then we clear them up.
At one point, you decided to share all your knowledge through cooking and meditation classes, catering and workshops. How did it all start?
Well, I've been meditating for, maybe about 20 years. I've been meditating for about 20 years. And then I just started doing like a free meditation class. And I can't wait to move and start doing that again. I live in a very small town right now, and there's not a lot of people that would probably attend here. But I know when I do it in other areas, we get a lot of people that are really interested in that. So, I really love sharing that because we all have such a huge, vast amount of peacefulness and tools to handle everything in our lives. But most people don't have that awareness of how to tap into that infinite supply within themselves. So I love sharing that. And then cooking classes, I guess I just I started doing that actually when I had a day job. 15 years ago, I started just bringing things into the girls I worked with and teaching them. I remember I had a blender and I'd bring my blender in and teach the ladies there how to make smoothies. And so I just, and people really, they loved it. And that's where the original seed of me wanting to teach healthy cooking came from, was the women I worked with in a furniture store so long ago. Yeah.
Wonderful.
It was fun.
Wonderful. Over the last few years, you've also published several books. What do you generally write about? And if you could recommend our viewers pick up one of your books, which one would it be and why?
People always ask me which one of my books I recommend, and I always reply that it's kind of like saying, which child do you love the most? You love all your children, so it's really hard to pick a favorite. But I'd say the first book I wrote definitely has the most. The first book is called Radiant Health, Inner Wealth. And that book has been referred to by a lot of my readers as their food Bible because it has, it's got 250 recipes, lots of color pictures. It tells you everything you need to know to switch over to a healthy plant-based diet. So it's got everything from how to shop, how to set up your kitchen, how to stock your kitchen, how to plan menus. And it gives you all different ideas on types of menus you can plan, how to eat balanced meals, glossary. And then it's got a whole holistic section as well. So that book has everything. Okay. And then my next book is called The 2-Week Wellness Solution. And that is basically like a foodie detox for people who want to lose weight quickly, get super healthy, but they actually don't want to starve themselves and they want to still eat. It works extremely well. And then my most recent book is called Radiance for Life. And that book is just a celebration of superfoods, the most nutrient-dense foods on the planet. And it didn't take that much work. I made them into delicious recipes. Those foods are really fun and easy to work with. So that's my most recent book. So I guess if you had to pick just one, the first one, but I do sell them as a set because it's nice to have all three for kind of different reasons.
Amazing. You're also a vegan. A lot of people think vegan food is expensive or can't taste good. What do you feel is the most common misconception about veganism, and why do people make that mistake?
That's a great question, Miriam. Gosh, I've been vegan for 22 years, and so for me, it's like second nature. It's like breathing. I don't even really think about it much. The common misconception maybe is that it's hard to be satisfied on a vegan diet. And I work with clients, I do a lot of coaching. And usually when people say they're not satisfied, it's so, for me, it's such an easy thing to fix, because usually it's just people aren't, half the time, people just aren't eating enough. And I love vegetables, but you can't just eat vegetables. You have to have enough calories. You can't feel good and thrive and have tons of energy if you just don't have the calories to keep you going. So I think that's a common misconception, but I think it's people just don't really, they're just kind of going in and they're trying it and they're not doing it correctly. And it's like anything, you just have to do it right or else you're going to have problems with it.
Right. Can we talk a little bit about your inner wellness regime? You write on your website how meditation and visualization made a world of difference in your life. What can you share about it?
Well, that's a great question. And this is really neat because I don't usually talk about this. I usually talk about food. And so it's neat that you're asking me questions about that other side of it that is so, so dear to my heart and so important. I would say that for me, it made a world of difference because I think I was in a kind of a transition phase. I had recently gone vegan. And I was really trying to clean up my life, you know, stop drinking. I never did a lot of drugs, but I completely cut out all of that partying lifestyle of being in college. And I really just found that I had a lot of anxiety and I was having anxiety attacks. And so what I did was I think a friend of mine told me to start doing a mantra. And so I started doing a mantra. And then I started, and I just was in a full attack mode because I just was like so unhappy with these anxiety attacks. They were so stressful. So I started doing visualization. I started doing self-hypnosis. I started doing the mantra. And then I started learning how to meditate. And I remember one day I was walking to class. I was still in college back then. This was like over 20 years ago. And I was walking to class and I remember feeling so joyful and happy and then just stopping in my tracks and going, oh my God, all this stuff I've been doing is working. I'm really happy. And it was like the first time I'd felt so happy in years. And I remember just, it hit me like a brick. I realized that everything I was doing was working. It was a great moment. I never can forget that moment when I realized that it actually had worked. And it just got better from there.
How does that tie in with your philosophy on Radiant Health Inner Wealth? And what does it stand for?
Radiant Health Inner Wealth is it's the name of my first book, and it kind of encompasses my whole philosophy. Radiant health to me means that health isn't about the absence of disease. Health is not about not going to the hospital. Health is about thriving. It's about feeling great. It's about being in tune with our bodies. It's about if we have anything that goes wrong, we can tune in and know instantly what that is and how to fix it. We are in control and we can take back our own power and be radiantly healthy. And it's, I guess I just want to say that it's not that hard. It just takes a commitment to being in a healthy place and eating well and doing the right things, having good habits. And it takes time. You know, I'm healthier now than I was when I was half my age. You know, I feel like as the older I get, the more it's easy to just be healthy and be radiantly healthy because those bad habits fall away more and more and more over the years. So it's a process and we're not perfect overnight, but we keep working at it and we keep putting in those good seeds. It's like a garden. We're planting every day. We're planting those good seeds and we're throwing the seeds in there and they just keep sprouting and sprouting and sprouting. So every day you just plant those seeds. And then the inner wealth to me means that each one of us has a wealth of peace and joyfulness and life and beauty within us. And that's our true wealth. I mean, I have no problem with money, but I mean, money's never going to buy me happiness no matter how much I have. So the true wealth is that inner wealth that's always within me, and it's within all of us. And so I like to give people awareness of those tools that they have to get in touch with that wealth.
Oh, great.
And to enjoy it.
Great. If you could just spend 5 minutes with someone who was in a terrible shape and wanted to live a healthier, happier life, what would you say to them?
If I had 5 minutes with someone, what would I say to them? I would try to listen to them, first of all, and I would try to find out where they were at and really tune in to where they were at. And then I would try to just be as much of a vessel for love and light to come through for them as I could be. And I don't know what I would say, because the most helpful thing I can ever do is to just get my own self and ego out of the way and just be an open vessel for that beautiful divine energy of the universe to come through and give them a gift. So that's what I would try to do. I try to get myself out of the way and just be there for them and be of service to them.
And today you work as a wellness coach, a healthy cooking instructor, mm-hmm. and speaker. In your wellness coaching practice, what has been the most impactful lesson you've learned this far?
Well, I know that I learn from every client. Every time I teach a class, every time I work with a client, they always teach me something new. It's really, really cool. And they always have amazing things to share with me too, especially clients that I've worked with for, you know, longer periods of time. It's really neat. I have one client that I work with, and she's amazing. She has gone through so much in her life. I can't even tell you, and I can't tell you. But yeah, she's gone through so, so much. And every time I talk to her, it's like I just see her growing a little bit more and a little bit more, and I have to keep reminding her and going, honey, look at where you were a year ago. Like, you, this is night and day. So the thing that really makes me happy is to really see the progress. And then I have another client who I've worked with for at least a year or two, and she's the same way. She just has changed so much. And I look at where she was 2 years ago and then now where she is today, and she's really come a long way. So, I mean, I think for me, coaching is a great example of the potential of us all as human beings and of our growth. And when people think that you can't change, it's just not true. We all can change. We all have that ability to transform ourselves.
What is the one question people never ask you about holistic healing that they really should?
Probably they should ask me over for dinner more. That's what they should ask me.
That's a great one.
Yeah. I don't know. What should people ask me? People ask me all kinds of things. Gosh, I don't know.
What are some of your goals for the rest of the year?
Well, I have a lot of goals, actually. This month, my goal is to finish my book with Dr. Mary Clifton. Dr. Mary Clifton, woo, had a brain freeze right there. Yes, I want to get my book done with Dr. Mary, and it should be done by, gosh, probably within the next 2 weeks. So I'm really excited about that. And that book is called Get Wasted. And it's basically a new take on our food addiction and how to turn that around. And so it's going to have 100 really yummy, addictive vegan entrees so people can kind of turn that food addiction around and start getting addicted to foods that really serve them. So, excuse me, I had a little, whoop, there, I think I got it. So I want to finish that book up this month. And then from there, Dr. Mary and I are launching a plant-based weight loss program. And so we're really wanting to find women who want, or men, it's usually women, but there are some guys that are doing it too. So we're looking for people who want to be directors of our program in their area. And it's a really nice win-win situation for everybody involved. So one of my goals for the year is to really get that off the ground and really get at least 100 to 200 Get Wasted centers across the country. And then I'm also working on a huge project with Carrie Otis, and she is a supermodel, former supermodel. She still models. She's an author, and she's a model, and she is an amazing woman that I just adore her. I adore Mary, too. I feel so grateful and blessed to work with such amazing, beautiful women who are just powerful, lovely women. So I'm working with Carrie on a project to empower women, and we're working on a book, and my goal with that is to have the book launched by this fall, and so that's very exciting. So lots of work goals, and I also just want to enjoy my life, and I'm getting married in the summer, and we're moving, so there's just, it's going to be an interesting year. There's a lot going on.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Where can people go to learn more about you online?
People can go, they can check out my books, of course, and they can go, I generally recommend just going to my website and looking at Radiant Health, and then it's a hyphen, innerwealth.com, so it's radianthealthinnerwealth.com, and from there you can go click over to my blog, and you can click to my Facebook and Twitter pages, and it's really, I'm a pretty easy person to connect with, so I really enjoy the people that active on those pages. It's right. A nice group.
Great. And yeah. I will make sure to put all the links below this video.
Great. Thank you.
You're most welcome. Tess, do you feel there's anything we've missed that you would like to cover today?
No, I just think what you're doing, Miriam, is wonderful. And you're showcasing women that are making a difference. And I appreciate you having a chat with me today. It was really nice to see you, your beautiful shining face in person and get to talk to you a little bit.
Thank you so much. I loved having you on the show, Tess.
Thank you. My pleasure.
And thank you so much for watching. My name is Miriam Kaladi, and I will see you on the next episode of Real Talk, Real Women.